So you start by winding your dental floss. Now, a lot of people want you to wind it like this around an index finger. I tend to do one, and then this leaves me this hand free to maneuver. So whichever way you want, but if you wanted to do it with the index finger like this, your rule of thumb is use your thumbs like this, and then use your middle finger to get the lower teeth. So thumbs to get the upper teeth, middle finger to get the lower teeth, and it's anchored, the floss is anchored on your index finger. So when you're flossing, the key points are to take the dental floss and move it to just inside the gum line so that you really get that bacteria and plaque and food that's stuck, just kind of where the gum meets the tooth. The other thing to keep in mind when you're flossing is you don't want to just go up and down and pop it back out. You want to scrub as you go up and down, and you want to pull the floss around the tooth in a C shape so that you get all the curved surfaces of the tooth. Because as you get the food particles and the plaque and the bacteria disturbed, you want to move to a fresh piece of floss. For young kids who find it hard to manage the floss in their fingers, we have this device from Gum, G-U-M. And so the way you cut about 12 inches of floss, you wind it round, you go up, and there's little grooves. You come across. Now, when you come across, you pinch it together a little bit to put some tension, and then you come back down here. And you give that a good wind up. Now, this will not enable you to get a fresh piece of floss. So what you can do is either with your fingers or have a Kleenex, just get the food particles off like that in between your teeth. And you can still scrub both surfaces of the tooth using this. He's just wiping it on his shirt. Awesome. Whatever works, right? So you're pushing against one tooth surface and you're pulling against the other so that you can scrub both surfaces. Yeah, and see how he flipped it around? Like, you'll feel for what's easiest that enables you to get to things. And we've got a little bit of blood happening there just because you probably haven't been flossing for a while, hey?
No, senor.
No, senor. So yeah, wind it around both fingers.
Do not lose the circulation.
Now see how his gums are starting to bleed a little? That's totally fine. That just is because he hasn't been flossing very much. And the blood is good because the blood helps to flush the bacteria out of those spaces. So when you switch to a tooth, go to a clean piece of floss. Because as you get the food particles and the plaque and the bacteria disturbed, you want to move to a fresh piece of floss. There you go, with the thumbs, that's right. Yeah, and you want to be gentle, right? Because you don't want to be like slashing your gums. You just want to gently get up and down. Now try to do the bottom teeth. When you have a rinse, get rid of your blood. Now to do the bottom ones, use your middle finger. Don't try to use your thumbs. So leave it wrapped.
Both middle?
Yeah. There you go. And maybe shorten up on your floss. You got too much length there. So wind it around your index finger to shorten it up. There you go. Great job. And remember to curve it in the C shape around the teeth. There you go. And don't saw into the gum. You got to be really careful and gentle with the gums. You don't want to cut the gums. You just want to loosen the food particles that are around there. Yeah, and now move to a fresh piece of floss. So unwind from one finger and wind from the other. Awesome job. Okay, so you can either floss before or after you brush your teeth. I've watched a number of videos from a number of dentists. Each of them has their own preference. So you go ahead. If you floss before you've brushed your teeth, you're gonna get a lot more guck out. And some dentists like that because then they feel that the tooth bristles can get into the cracks a little bit more because you've cleared all of the food gunk in your teeth. Others prefer to brush with this first and then use the floss to get what the toothbrush missed. So it's totally up to you. I haven't seen any data or stats on, you know, one way being better than the other. Okay, I want to show you the way that I take Quick Plus Bone Matrix after I brush my teeth with Sonicare Electric UV Sterilization Toothbrush. I have my measuring cup, which I know where the 1 tablespoon amount is, just stays in my bathroom. Now you can take it and swish it straight like this, but I prefer to dilute it a little bit because this is just a little bit strong for me. So I have filtered tap water so I can use it right out of the tap. So now I just take the solution and I swish it all around my mouth for 1 to 2 minutes.